Hey everyone, Mr. Happy here, and today we're going to be talking about leveling from 1 to 50 in Final Fantasy XIV. Now for your first job in Final Fantasy XIV, the main scenario pretty much holds your hand all the way through to max level, but a lot of new players have started up as of late, and they ask, how do they level a second job after they've already used the main scenario, even if they just want to try something out for a little bit of fun? 1 to 50 seems so daunting after doing all of that, even if you've read all the guides and watched all the videos in the world. So in this video, I'm going to show you how you can get a second job in Final Fantasy XIV from level 1 to 50 in under 8 hours. Strap in, because we're going to go fast. First of all, in Final Fantasy XIV, you can get all sorts of EXP bonuses. Preferred Worlds grant a massive EXP bonus for at least 90 days when making a fresh character. The brand new Ring from the Novice Hall is a nice boost up until level 30. If you recruit a friend, or even if you have the A Realm Reborn Collector's Edition, there's different helmets you can get that give you a little bit of an early game EXP boost. Pre-ordering Endwalker will net you an EXP boosting earring all the way up to level 80. In fact, even level 81 it works until. Joining a free company with the Heat of Battle action active will provide a nice little boost, and of course, eating food gives you a little 3% boost. You also get a 100% EXP bonus if your second job is a lower level than your first. So if you have a level 30 monk, and then you decide you want to go try Gladiator, you'll automatically gain 100% more EXP until your Gladiator hits 30. This bonus carries all the way up to level 70, and then it's reduced to 50% between 70 and 80, and even that's going to see an update when Endwalker comes out. For my 1 to 50 video here, I used a Friendship Circlet, which was a 20% boost to level 25, the brand new ring, which is 30% until level 30, an old Aetherite earring, which is basically the same as the one you get from pre-ordering for Endwalker, but it's just, you know, 10 levels less, only to level 70. That's 30% until level 70, and then I actually got rid of almost all of my Rested EXP before doing this. I don't know why I just decided that I was going to do it without any Rested EXP. I did make sure to eat food throughout all of this, and I had Heat of Battle 2 from a free company mate, who actually was an old college friend. Thanks for the invite. So we've unlocked a new class, your level 1. Grab your level 1 class quest and head out to the nearby fields to complete it. Complete the quest objective, and then just spam kill monsters that are equal to or higher than your current level. This gives you what's called a chain bonus, which will further boost the EXP you receive when killing monsters in the overworld. However, it only accrues when monsters are the same or a higher level than you, so make sure you're constantly moving up to the next level of mobs. All the while, be sure to try and complete your hunting log, basically move through the list to kill the enemies as you actually gain levels. Finally, if you see any non-boss fates, definitely do them. They have tons of monster spawns, and those can add up quick, along with the EXP from actually completing the fate. In total, this takes about 20 minutes, depending on your efficiency. If you have any rested EXP, it'll get burned through before you get out of this level range, but it drastically speeds it up. Honestly, for me, I think this is probably one of the best spots to actually have rested EXP from 1 to 50, because the next several parts go super quick. If you want to help speed up this level 1 to 10 process, consider grabbing cheap level 5 and 8 weapons from an NPC vendor in town. You'll get weapons from your class quests anyway, but I recommend that you skip those until you're almost level 10. Ideally, you'll turn in your level 5 class quest, get the EXP from that, that makes you level 10, and then immediately do your level 10 class quest. Or you could just get to level 10, then go back and hand in your level 1 class quest, and then also do levels 5 and 10. So once you're level 10 and all of your class quests are up to date, take a trip over to Camp Tranquil in the Southern Shroud. If you don't have lead quests unlocked here, do them real quick, because that's how we're going to power level for a bit. Camp Tranquil has a lead quest called Adamantoy's Tears. Now if you don't see it on the list, you're going to have to swap to a higher level job and complete one of the lead quests on the list in order to refresh it and actually make Adamantoy's Tears appear. The only objective for this leave quest is to pick up 5 Adamantoy's eggs, and it requires no mandatory combat. You want to carefully pick up all 5 eggs without being killed by any of the random monsters or from the turtles that will actually spawn, and then turn in the leave quest and repeat. We're aiming to very quickly get to level 16 with this method. Few notes. First, make sure to raise the difficulty of the leave quest to plus 4 whenever activating it. This ensures the best possible experience points. Second, you are about 20-ish levels under all the monsters in this area, so getting hit means you'll probably die, if not in one hit, in 2 or 3. Fortunately, the only real mobs in the area that are threatening are the birds along the western side of the camp, and they're pretty easy to avoid. There is also sometimes a fate that's right on top of 2 of the potential egg spawns. If this happens, perhaps swap to a higher level job and quickly kill off the fate mobs to despawn it. Finally, get used to clicking on eggs that have turtles spawn right on top of them. You'll need to be quick or the turtle will get the chance to smack you in the face. This may take a few practice tries, so set a home point and camp tranquil until you get your rhythm here. Now you can do this right from level 1, and it gets you from 1 to 10 super quick. I just don't prefer the extra chance that I'm gonna get one shot by something. Mobs even aggro from further away when you're really low level, so I just didn't want to take the risk. In total, doing this took me from level 10 to 16 in a little under half an hour. I did stop to do my level 15 class quest as well, which you should definitely do before the next step because it does come with another skill. So now you're level 16, but we really need to be level 20 before our next phase. For this, we will do one singular leveling roulette. The EXP from these at this level is absolutely nuts, especially if you have any EXP boosts. I queued in at level 16, and while I was in queue, I just continued doing this Adamantoise tier leave quest while waiting in the queue for about 10 minutes. Then, I was already level 17 after doing that a few times, so I went from level 17 to 22 in a single roulette. While this is the only roulette I did from 1 to 50 for this video, keep in mind that if you're taking this a lot slower and you don't want to go super fast like I'm telling you you can in this video, try doing a leveling roulette a day. It helps a lot. So now we're level 22 and this is where things get extra fun. But there's a bit of setup before we can actually continue. There's a feature in this game called Adventurer Squadrons. I've made tons of videos about them, and that's unlocked after reaching second lieutenant with your grand company. Yes, that means you'll already need one job at level 50, with the Grand Company upgrades to go along with it, but it's a worthwhile investment. Once you have squadrons unlocked, it will take a few days of training and sending them out on missions to get them to level 20. Once there, it's a matter of finishing a special mission that gets flagged for you. It can be kind of annoying, but it might just take you a try or two to get it done. If the squadron comes back successful from that mission, you will gain access to command missions, which just basically lets you run dungeons with your squad. And that's how we're doing levels 20 to 50. Grab the appropriate roles from your squad mates and queue into dungeons with them. Mind you that every time you queue in, it will cost Grand Company seals, so make sure to take every piece of gear you can get from every dungeon you do and trade it in for seals. Make sure you probably do that before you even start doing this so you have enough seals to even get started. With this method, I got from level 22 to 30 in about an hour, and then averaged just under 5 levels an hour from that point on. Of course, make sure to complete class and job quests all along the way. The skills and the bonus gear help a lot. But in total, it took me just over 7 hours to get from levels 1 to 50, and that's with me actually taking some breaks that I didn't even calculate out of this time, so it's actually a decent bit shorter than that. Now some squadron advice, and trust me, you're going to want to be listening to this part in particular. 1. Immediately go into your actions and traits, find your squadron actions, and put engage, disengage, and squadron's limit break somewhere easy to access on your hotbar. These NPCs are dumb as dirt, so you're going to need to command them until the squadron tank has aggro on everything before you even start attacking if you are a non-tank. This is the most finicky thing about them, but once you master it, it goes pretty quick. Now, if you're the tank, my only recommendation is not to do big pulls. The healer is slow to react on healing and doesn't handle big pulls well at all, especially if you're the tank because you don't get nearly as many potential defensive benefits as the squadron tanks can get. Now, if you're the healer, on the other hand, go nuts so long as you can safely let the tank both get aggro and stay alive. Next, as you complete dungeons, they actually level up as well. If they are too low of a level to do a dungeon, you will not be able to access it. Consider sending them on additional training missions before you use them for the first time, and make sure to send them on missions overnight to help them level as well. If you're actually not leveling in a given day, definitely do their training missions as well. Those help a lot. I know it sounds like it's a lot of setup, but it's really just a few button presses a day to do this, and their leveling speed is pretty quick, and the leveling speed you'll get out of it is too good to pass up. They'll also occasionally learn different tactics that boost their stats upon dungeon completion. Ideally, your DPS and healer squad mates get a bunch of offensive boosts, and your tank, I like to stick with independent tactics. Basically, for non-tanks, you want whatever has the highest damage increasing stat for their tactics, and for tanks, you kind of want a mix, because you want them to deal more damage, but you also want them to be pretty safe, especially with that fairly dumb healer. So, for me, independent tactics was the safest bet for the tank NPCs. For gear, you'll get plenty from the dungeons themselves. If you do have spare seals, though, consider grabbing some weapons or armor from your grand company itself. They have tons of options for all sorts of level ranges after 20. And then finally, some dungeon-to-dungeon advice. For level 20 to 24, you should just need to do one or two Holotallies. If you were like me and were already level 22, I just had to do a single one. Try to spam engage with them on the first boss so they do not attack the small flames. Consider just commanding them to kill the elementals on the second boss while you flee out of the water to safety. And on the final boss, make sure that you command them to help kill the fire elementals, but leave the tiny flames alone. The healer should be able to handle the damage from those just like they did on the first boss. Make sure to complete these all the way through as well. You need your squad mates to be getting EXP from participating, and they will only get EXP upon completing a dungeon, so do not leave them early. Now at level 24, you're gonna have to do Total Rock. No big advice here, just make sure that if they get trapped behind a web, that you engage them on the web to break it fast. For the final boss, I recommend using the Squadron Limit Break on the tail, killing it, and then you should instantly murder the boss with the damage up. Try to spam engage on the boss towards the end so they focus finishing it instead of killing the second set of adds, but definitely kill the first set. You'll have to do Total Rock all the way until level 32, and you'll get about a level a run. Make sure that before you go into the level 32 dungeon that you finish your class quest and unlock your job. From this point on, if you're actually using the Heavensward jobs, which start at level 30, then you don't need to worry about any of that. But I would recommend doing your first level 30 job quest, as it does give you a new skill for those jobs. At level 32, you're going to be going into Brayflox's Longstop, but beware that the healer squadmate is extra dumb here. They can run off and try to help NPC goblins sometimes, aggro a bunch of mobs, and just abandon your tank. That's fine most of the time, since even if you have to kill those extra monsters, there's a lot of EXP to gain per mob from here. I normally just run the most direct path through, maybe killing a couple of extra enemies, but honestly, I would say it's not a bad idea to maybe kill as many things as possible. They just truck through them once you get used to this. For the final boss, you'll be the only one who can be targeted by the Toxic Spit. Now, if the boss is standing in the Toxic Spit, it regens health. So, since you're the only one who can be targeted, you'll want to place it out of range. If you're a melee, as soon as you see the boss turning to face you to cast it, just run away, drop the puddle, and then get back to attacking the boss. If you don't, you're going to have to do some really funky positioning with the tank squadmate, and it is not good. Once again, you'll be doing this dungeon for a very long time. You'll be doing it all the way until level 41 when you get to Stone Vigil. Get caught up on your job quests, and then that's going to be the dungeon you probably do until level 50. It's definitely better than Zamiel Darkhold at level 44, and Ormvale, it's okay other than the second boss. The squadmates basically ignore all of the ground damage as well as some of the boss mechanics, but that second boss is really annoying for squadmates, so that's up to you. You can do it if you want to experiment with some of your newer skills, but you can also just do Stone Vigil, and honestly, you probably won't even notice the difference level-wise. As for Stone Vigil itself, just remember that on the second boss, you're the only one who can operate the cannons to knock the dragon out of the sky. Other than that, they fend for themselves pretty well. Consider clearing side rooms even, as the EXP from them is really, really good. And with that, you're clear to get to level 50. Now, that's not to say these are the only ways to level. I have a video that's every possible way to level in the entire game, and it covers a bunch of other methods. Palace of the Dead is very popular. You unlock it after level 17, I believe, and then you can use it all the way from 1 to 60. I just find it so agonizingly boring, especially when you have to do it for multiple jobs. I can't recommend it. I can say it's good, but I can't recommend it. Your daily roulettes, of course, are huge. The longer you spread this period apart, the more leveling roulettes you'll get to do, the more Recity XP you'll get. Make sure you're logging out inside of Sanctuary so you get plenty of Recity XP. And then the more EXP items you have, the faster this will accelerate as well. You could also just do normal dungeons if you're a tank or a healer. You don't have to do squad mates. You can just do dungeons with normal players if you want. But the squad mates, I felt like this was a good way of recommending people to do it on their own, because you can speed up a lot of these methods by playing with friends. A friend can help power level you from 1 to 20 on that leave quest that I mentioned, for example. Like, you can sit in camp and they can run around and collect all the Adamantoise eggs for you, and then you just turn it in over and over again. But this is a nice, reliable way to, on your own for the most part, other than that leveling roulette, get a job from 1 to 50 in a very short period of time. And hopefully, you found this useful. And with that, that's going to be a wrap for my quick 1 to 50 leveling guide. If you're interested in anything after level 50, well, those videos won't be too long because it's a very straightforward answer. But again, check out that Every Way to Level video. It will cover every level range that you need. But for now, be sure to like, favorite, subscribe, and share, and stay tuned. We'll be doing a lot of new player stuff, recap stuff, a lot of just stuff until Endwalker comes out. But anyway, I'll see you then, and until next time, take care.